Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Today we will be playing a new pre-release game called DinoSystem that was launched on Steam a couple of days ago. I have not played this at all. I've just opened up the menu screen here. So we will see how it goes. I don't know, Fraps is kind of giving me some issues, so I'm having to continually roll over the menu. I'm not sure how the video would turn out, but let's give it a go and, well, we'll see. This episode might be a little longer than usual, but I think it'll be okay, because this is more like a let's try than a let's play. So, okay. Survival mode, season, autumn, winter, spring, summer sounds good. Winter sounds bad. Spring sounds kind of easy. God mode. Okay. Initial fertility. Is that talking about my character or is it talking about... I don't know. Island size. We'll go with 100%. I assume that's what the developer designed this game for, but this game is pretty dynamic from what I've seen and what I've read. So well, the game's screen will be obscured while the map is generated, showing random game hints. Okay. I don't know if the volume will be too loud, because there's no volume controls. There's no graphical controls, but this is a, as I said, it's a pre-release, or sorry, an early release game. I usually do not like to play early release games, because, or even to buy early release games, because first of all, they can be really, really, I'm trying not to use, you know what, never mind. It can be really, really borked, if you guys know what that means. And there's been a lot of times where the God tutorial enabled. I don't want that. Game hints enabled. Metric? Makes sense, but no. What's this? Turn the character with mouse mode. I kind of don't want to use my... Man, the interface I wish were better, but this is an alpha release, an early release game. Windowed mode, I wish they had fixed sizes so I didn't have to drag the window size manually. Normal map was this. Okay, my computer's not too terrible, so hopefully I'll be able to play this. It's a top-down type game. But I have heard complaints about stuff. Oh, cool. There's a volume control here. Hopefully I don't set it too low. Warning sound enabled. Hey, dope. Okay. Whatever. Yeah. As I said, it's a top-down game. I don't know if I like this. I don't know, it seems kind of dated. Skin tone. Let's make you alabaster. Okay. Yeah, whatever. I don't know what this means. Wait. Okay, athletics. Okay, so I get additional points. I guess I can, increasing metabolism will allow your body to adapt more quickly over time according to your lifestyle and will make you swifter, but also less resilient and nutrition efficient. What? Okay, body muscle will make you stronger and more resilient, but also heavier and much less nutrition efficient. Not sure what that means. Increasing body fat will make you much heavier and slower, but will release energy to survive starvation, allowing you to keep going without eating for longer periods of time. Note, the number doesn't represent a body index. Okay. I wasn't thinking it did, but anyways. Alright, so what else do we have? Both physical and mental skills improve as you play, but may also decay if the related ability is rarely used on hardcore difficulty. Alright. Yeah, the interface could be a lot better, but it is pre-alpha. As I was saying, I usually do not buy early release games because they tend to be borked and very, I don't know, lacking, and you pay money for it. It's fine if they go ahead and fix it all, but the problem is a lot of times the games, they get, like, quote-unquote, released with a lot of bugs and they don't get updated. They also... I don't know if you guys can hear that. That's thunder. I probably shouldn't be on the computer while it's thundering, but oh well. These games get released, and it basically they're quote unquote released, but it's broken still, and basically the developers have abandoned it because they're probably not getting as much money as they thought. You know, there's a lot of people coming in from, what is it, Greenlight, the Greenlight program on Steam, and they're first time developers. Whatnot. So I usually don't like to buy them because you're not really paying for the full game, and you may not get the full game, but you still pay for it. This looked interesting enough, and the guy does update like quite frequently, apparently. Hopefully he'll keep the momentum up, and he'll finish off the game, but we'll see. Alright, so let's continue. Melee increases damage and pushback dealt by fighting barehanded or with melee weapons. It also increases your chances to cause blood loss with cutting weapons. During the game, the skill is improved by performing any melee attack, even chopping wood. Alright. Range increases damage and accuracy of ranged throwing weapons such as bows and spears. During the game, the skill is improved by performing ranged attacks. Endurance increases your maximum breath. Okay. During the game, the skill is improved by performing actions that consume your breath, like, I assume, breathing. Resilience increases your maximum health. During the game, the skill is improved by receiving damage from animals, cold temperature, and sandstorms. And fire. Alright. Resilience. Maximum health. Crafting increases the speed at which your craft items. I think I'm having trouble reading the font. Either that, I'm just rushing through it. The final quality of the item at higher levels allow you to craft advanced items. It also increases your ability in carving stones during the game. The skill is improved by crafting items or carving stones. Alright, fire making. Alright, I feel really kind of tired. Reading all this text. Usually I would have played the game a bit, but I am totally going in blind this time. Blind. Well, it is spring. Gathering increases your chances to gather resources from trees, plants, and rock deposits, and in some cases it increases the quality of the item acquired. During the game, the skill is improved by gathering, butchering, blah blah blah. Allows you to inspect an animal's stats such as health, hunger, stamina, etc. Missing comma there. And in future, it will also govern your ability to tame animals when the future is released or introduced. During the game, the skill is improved by watching animal. What? Well, inspect. I don't know. I know the guy's has mentioned that English isn't his first language, so sentence structure, even for a native speaker, can be a skill that is not easily, how would you say, easily obtainable. I don't know. All right, let's do this. Endurance, yeah, let's max out the, let's bring up the endurance a little bit. Resilience probably needs to be higher. I have 50 points left. Crafting, let's go and put fire making just in case. I don't think it'll be a big deal, but whatever. Crafting was probably what we'll be doing a lot. Gathering, yeah, why not? Butchering. Okay. Ranged. Metabolism. Let's see. All right. Day one. Is there a pause? Oh, P for pause. All right. Welcome to DinoSystem. This tutorial will help you familiarize with familiar to help you familiar. I can't. That's me. I can't pronounce that word. To help you become more familiar with the basic concepts of the game, you can drag this window where you please. All right, I would have worded that a little differently, but that's okay. I'm not an expert. If you want to pause the game in order to read the tutorial instructions in total relax, I definitely would have changed that. Press the P key. All right, would have. All right. I wish the interface had more intuitive controls, but I haven't really played this, so I don't know. Maybe this is better. Because as a first-time player, or even a player coming back to a game, you might not remember the controls. So I wish it was a little bit more on-screen available. But then you got the problem of real estate. Let's read this. This tutorial is quite long. Oh man, this tutorial is quite long. If you don't want to focus on it, you can continue playing the game and ignore it, dragging the window on the edge of the screen to partially hide it, or you can disable it from the setting menu. Escape settings. Yeah, like I wish there was a some sort of setting thing, some sort of interface thing that showed the basic controls, so you're not totally like dependent on remembering buttons or keys to activate to open up all these menus or do all these things. If you disable and enable it again, the tutorial will restart the last chapter. Restart from the last chapter. Press tab to open the game guide. I don't know if that's a comma. I don't know. I edit people's stuff occasionally, so I can't help it when I see stuff like that. Even when I'm reading novels, I like a lot of times I'll point out or I'll note the grammar mistakes. I'm not really great in grammar to begin with, or punctuation, but I seem to be better than, or more. I don't know. I don't want to pat myself on the back because I'm not great. But anyways, where you can learn the controls and get all the information you need to face every challenge offered by DinoSystem. Note that the guide is still a work in progress and contains only a fraction of the final content. All right, DinoSystem is a complex survival game where the player is immersed in an emergent ecosystem simulation. Okay, I'm not sure if that word recesses. I gotta stop. Okay, your objective in survival mode is to survive as long as you can, and in the best way possible. There is not yet a story as a background for the survival mode. Do we really need a story for this type of game? I don't know. I don't think so. Unless you have an objective, but it's a sandbox kind of mode, I assume. And do you really need something? You just want to muck around. At least that's what I would like to do. Make sure to visit our forum and suggest us a possible scenario. Everything you do has an impact on the island ecology. If you kill all animals of a species, it will become extinct and the ecosystem will be changed forever with the risk of collapse. You don't want this to happen since your life depends on the flora, fauna, and fauna included in it. The world of DinoSystem is like a living organism. See, that's what I like. This type of concept where it's like dynamic. You're just plopped into something and things happen around you. You can sit there and wait and have things happen without your interference. Or you can interfere and totally muck things up. It's kind of like a demented sort of, not demented, maybe a more interactive sort of, oh, what do they call those things? Fish tanks. Anyways, it doesn't revolve around you, but you're a part of it. Exactly. All right, that's the thing that really attracted me to this. And I did see some videos on the Steam page itself, and it seems okay. It seems interesting. It's not a complete game, so this, take that into consideration as you watch this. I might do an update. I definitely won't do a Let's Play until it's more complete, but if it's good enough, I will consider it. At least like one playthrough. Unless I die really quick, or my character dies really quick, and then I might do another playthrough. Alright, let's learn the view controls. Oh. Alright, mouse in, mouse out. I assume that's the case. I didn't even read. Note that in survival mode, you can't zoom out too much, while in god mode, you can nearly see the whole map at maximum zoom. Okay. DinoSystem has 2D graphics with... Okay. The game, I don't know why he explained this, but the game allows you to freely move the view. In order to do this, hold down the Alt key and move the cursor towards the direction you want the view to move. What? Okay, maybe it's because that's why. Whoa, scrolling speed, chill. All right. So I had to unpause it. All right. This section is called scouting. I wish it would allow me to do it while I was paused. The further you see, the denser the fog of war is. I hope that's like toggleable. because some people might not care for that, preventing you from being able to see everything on a map. Now try moving the views. Blah, 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 blah. I'm not going to. Yeah, I can't do it while here. Ugh, come on, you're forcing me to do it. Are you serious? Alright. So basically, when I release Alt, it snaps back to my character. Okay, that's what he's basically saying. Holy crap, there's still more interface stuff. Let's get a quick overview of the interface. Dino has a very hardcore approach on survival, and requires you to keep track of several indicators. The most important are the status icons. Isn't I don't know what hardcore means, but whatever. I guess his sentence. I really need to stop correcting this guy's sentences. He mine aren't that great to begin with. And I know his English isn't his primary language, but considering that it isn't, it is pretty decent. So I should really stop. You know. Yeah. Anyways, some of them may not be visible now. Ooh, autosave. Sun exposure, wind exposure, la 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 la. I don't really care about it yet. Okay, let me pause. The last one on the right, muscle. Ah, okay. See, that's a little bit more intuitive. Muscle soreness. I'm just standing there. The stat has a double function since it allows you to build muscle assuming you eat enough calories and proteins, calm and rest, but at the same time reduces your strength. Okay. As the tutorial gets explained and polished, more info will be added to it about the function of every icon. Since the previous icons also need an in-depth explanation, but muscle soreness is the one that really could confuse more players. Okay. I'm getting tired of this. Needs. Okay, let me see this. Red arrow. What? I see it flashing, you don't need to tell me. Shows the difference between the necessities of the character. From top to bottom we have health, stamina, your need for sleep, nutrition, both calories and proteins, and hydration. The mechanics related to them are quite complex and would require an in-depth explanation. The stomach does not show the need for food, but how your belly is full, both of solids and liquids. Okay, that's interesting. The addition of this mechanic is necessary so that what you eat is also important. Nutrients density filling ratio should play. Okay. The character info panel check. You don't need to tell me, it's blinking. First of all, this will be overhauled in future updates and will have a proper screen with blah 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 blah. Okay. Press I. Okay. On the left side, you can see the character physical stats such as metabolism, how fast your body adapts to your lifestyle, muscles, fat. Why would you call it metabolism? Metabolism is how... Wait, I don't even know how to describe it. Anyways, body weight and strength. All these variables change as you survive. Depending on how you survive, what and how much you eat, your physical activities, your sleep, and so on. Strength represents your overall condition and is influenced by a lot of parameters such as muscle, health, stamina, nutrition, and so on. It is very important because it determines the speed and quality of most of the physical actions the character performs. Huh. Maybe I should have increased my strength instead of putting it willy-nilly. On the right side of the window we have... Was there a way to increase strength? Oh well, never mind. On the right side of the window we have the character skills. They improve as the related action is performed, and the higher the skill... Sorry, I'm trying to stop myself from correcting or rewriting this sentence in my head. The higher the skill, the better the outcome of the related action will be. For example, high crafting skill allows you to create more complex items and better in quality. Again, I'm trying to stop myself from correcting his sentence. Note that if you selected hardcore difficult, blah blah blah, don't care about that. All right, now let's learn how to move. Oh man. Keep pressing W. Keep press W to move forward and S. I'm gonna have to use this. Anyways. Animation's kinda smoother than I thought. Still a little bit. I don't know why it's suddenly blinking red. Wish that would have been explained in the tutorial first. Note that when you move backwards you can attack while running back exploit. I don't think it's considered an exploit, just a game mechanic. S- setting or directly pressing T. So basically, in the beginning, they had asked me to set the setting, but I didn't know what they were talking about. Or I did, but I didn't know how it would come into play. Oh man, it's this. My timer is like really, really long. This let's try might be really, really long, but that's all right. It'll be a one-off for now. But this tutorial is kind of long and it's a bit tedious. But anyways, once he if he revamps this before like an actual release or in a further date at a further time, then it will be good. But for now, it's kind of tedious. I think he should make it so that it's give more bare essential stuff, and then the rest can be added as hints or whatever. And having us actually do the stuff that they say will lock into memory a little bit better. Anyways, press shift in order to sprint. All right, withdraw drains your breath very quickly. Breath is the blue bar. Only, I don't know. Find space to use to jump, your athletic skills, along with the other factors decide the height of the jump. If you jump high enough, you can avoid certain obstacles and even some dinosaurs. Interesting. Learn how to interact with objects. Find a stone and go very close to it and wait, how do I wait a second, did I select mouse? Okay. Here's a stone. Now you can hover the mouse and you can clearly see that the name is colored. The color is an indicator of the object's conditions. Different objects, blah blah blah. In DinoSystem, every object is affected by its surroundings. Sounds right. Blah blah blah. Oh, come on. See the tooltip next to the cursor? Man, after this tutorial, I'm gonna have to restart this because I've already lost like a lot of daylight, I think, and my conditions are fading and all that, and I'm imagine if I hadn't played this as pause, I probably would have died in the middle of a tutorial. Or my character would have. Tooltip. When comp indicate that the stone can be used as a weapon, but it's also a component. I don't know how you would fix that so that the interface is more intuitive. Well, I'm not here to fix the game, I'm here to play it, show you guys. The no percent number is the condition of the object. The time shown numerical. No, is the time shown numerically. What? Then we have the different status. I don't know what that means, but okay. Okay, now let's move this stone. You can move any small objects wherever, blah blah blah. Note that if you drag it too far from the character, the object will be automatically dropped. Try dragging the stone and place it at a. All right. I'm slightly thirsty. Yeah, me too, buddy. Well done. You can also run with the dragging trick while dragging drag on what an object in order to quickly carry it. Now let's hold the stone in your hand. All right. Yeah, this is cool. All right, as you can see, there are various slots representing a specific part of the character. Oh, come on. Shoot. Shush your mouth. Actually, that's kind of cool how he shivers like a. Anyways, the two ones in front. I don't know about that. I kind of wish they had like a proper inventory type window. As programmed by years and years of RPGs. But okay, that's not too bad. It's an interesting way to do it. But like I said, I would have preferred just a straight up window. The right hand is just used to hold an item. What? Let's focus on the two. Your hand. Why is my character left-handed? Most people in the world are right-handed. This means that in order to. It shouldn't matter. Oh, I don't even know what. How do you pop. I wish you could drag it instead of just dropping it. I don't care. Now let's learn to defend yourself. Holy crap. I am pressing X. I don't know. Kind of frustrated with the interface at the moment. Well, not frustrated, kind of annoyed. And this tutorial is like really, really tedious. I mean, I've been here like half an hour already. While it's white, it means the attack is being formed, and when turning red, it means the attack is finished. And now you can't attack until the red bar fades out. What does this have to do with range? For range attacks, you need to press X two times. What? The first time to trigger a normal attack, the second time to actually throw. What? Let's try it. Kind of really tedious. One more thing, you can switch to mouse turn mode to move and aim and s I enabled it in the window, but it didn't work. Light of. Oh my goodness, I don't care anymore. I'm probably gonna have to restart. Drink rain. Better find cover. I'm thirsty. Alright, I wish you could like hold down the button or something. Day two. All right. See, maybe I shouldn't have skipped the last part of that tutorial because it seems to be important. Okay, maybe I'll get fruits. How do I open inventory again? Okay. Oh, I can use the branch as a weapon. That's the stone I threw. Light a fire. Need a stone in each hand? Okay, well, I've stunned there. Let me zoom out a bit. There's branches. Fruit. Bad. Oh, hello, fruit. Ugh. So right click to interact with it. Alright, here's another stun. I'm just running for the heck of it, I guess, because man, why you? Hey. All right, look at this. What is that? Great, I can't interact with these bones. All right. Yeah, interface needs a bit of work, and I'm trying to how do I sleep? All right, I should take a nap. I'm naked. Try sleeping. The process is, man, craft and build. Cool. No, you should tell me what components, or open up a window or something. Don't just say, ugh. How the heck am I supposed to get? Alright, bedroll. What? I can't do anything. Ugh, this is stupid. Alright. Actually, when I click it, alright, so now, where's my leaf? I know you're tired, but build yourself a fire first. Need more fuel to light a proper fire. Hey, cool. Stupid. Alright. Interface is it's really weird. How do I get so much water? Alright, how do I cancel sleep? I am slightly hungry. Well, time to find some. No, old tree. Spoiled. What's that? Okay, never mind. Dude. Alright, if you're cold, run. Good enough. Oh, it's spoiled. I'm working on it, you punk. I hope you get eaten soon. I'm tired of dealing with you. I'm thinking of just dumping. Oh, you know what? Let me see if I can't make camp here. Whoa. Okay. So I have two stones here. Let me dump you guys here. Getting soaked. We'll deal with it. Ooh. Yeah. Wonder if this is faster or why can't I find stones from in the maybe I can't. Ugh. You're not gonna let me freaking run in the rain. Wish there was a button that made it so that I could run and dung. That's not good. I don't know what I could do with dung. I hate how you have to go under the tree to actually see it, see anything. So basically what I'm trying to do is gather stones for a fire. I think I have 5 or 6, so let me run around some more. Hopefully while running around I can also, man, I can also get some break. All right, so this is a big stone. The equipment interface is kind of cumbersome, but I guess if you play it long enough, I hope at least it will be able to get used to it. All right, so it looks like I can break these stones. Break. All right, so let's build a fire pit. What are you talking about? Break. All right, let's try this again. Okay, so I guess you have to have the stones in a circle of influence. Before you can actually do it, kind of tedious. All right, good job. Now I would suggest drinking. How are you getting soaked? Oh yeah, because you're in a freaking lake. All right, well, looks like I need to find another stone because I destroyed all my... What? Stone found. Can you pick it up? All right. You're also kind of hungry. No, that's not what I want to do. All right. All right, I don't know if that will work, but man, I'm not getting used to the controls at all. Stunner broken. You idiot, what the hell's wrong with you? Sorry guys, I'm trying to concentrate on this. It's so annoying. What happened? What? Man, screw this. This is, tedious. Sleep. I don't know guys, I'm having a hard time getting used to the interface. It's really, really cumbersome. Ah, crap, dinosaurs. Should I run? Please don't trample on my fire pit. Even worse, don't crap on my fire pit. Actually, maybe crapping on it is not a bad idea. All right, since that guy is there, what I'll do is I'll go back here and get more stones. I wish you would, like, pick it up, unless I actually have something in my hand. It's kind of tedious to have the stone. In your hand before you can. You did crap in my pit. No! I don't know guys, I'm kind of getting tired of this. How do I craft fire pit? Maybe it should say like dismantle fire pit instead of just and dung. I think I'll drop it off to the side. Okay, leave. Shut the hell up, man. Maybe when this stumble mechanic is kind of stupid. Yeah, this stone mechanic is really ridiculous. Exhausted again. All right, fine. Sleep. can sleep under the rain because you're an idiot. No, you actually get a fire going after like 5 days. What is that? Oh, yeah. Alright, fine, sleep. I don't know, guys. Like I said, the interface is kind of wonky. Yes, genius, 'cause you forced me to. All right. That's what I'll do. I'll dismantle this. Let me just drag the stones over. I even dragged the poop over because I think I can use the poop as. Ugh, stupid stumble mechanism. Alright. What the hell, man? I should enable, maybe if he wants to really fix that. Or kind of fix that with the stubborn mechanism, whatever he was saying. Maybe he should do it only when you're actually running or and shooting. Oh, did they? Where did that poop go? So what I'm trying to do is trying to move this somewhere else. All right, screw it. Let me just sleep so you could shut up. All right, so what I'm gonna do is bring the stones over to under tree and on the other side of that pond. The pond is there for drinking water, and then from there I build the fire and hopefully. He won't complain about the. Won't you shut up? Oops. Yeah, that was bad. And let's drink some water. Drink again. I don't know if it's easier to just pick this up. And run with it, or to actually drag and drop it like this. I almost want to see if I can throw it. Oh, come on. Alright, maybe this will up my athleticism as well. I don't know why the screen is got a red hue to it. Maybe it's done. So I think those things that I keep dropping are seeds, or once I eat the fruit. Don't know how they play come into play because I can't seem to pick them up. We're close to summer. Maybe I don't even need the fire anymore. Freaking. I wish you could use the ferns and the tree, the twigs or whatever to make like a temporary shelter so you're not having to depend on the trees. And as your crafting goes up, it would of course make the tree, sorry, the shelter more advanced. What is that? That's gotta be a. Alright, that's not cool. Which direction is it coming from? Oh, sorry, I probably shouldn't have said that. You know, maybe he doesn't care about me. If that's the case, let me eat that. You know what? Even a moron would know how to store stuff under his armpits or something, so I wish you could, like, store more stuff. Okay. I'm doing pretty well, health-wise, or food and water-wise. Let's do that. Come on, hurry up. At least I'm getting a crafting increase. Alright. Probably need to find more stones to make fire. Okay. Alright, that's not that great of a stone, so let me find another stone. How hard is it to find a stone from a boulder? Just, I don't know. I wish the leaves would not, well, I guess it doesn't matter, because I... Alright. Alright, get a branch. So at least I can get a fire going. Just like how you just have the materials around here to build this thing, I wish it would just same as lighting a fire. More fuel? What are you talking about? I have like a ton of stuff there. Deal with it. You idiot. That's stupid. No, I don't want to dismantle. Ugh. Man, that's ridiculous. I had two stones there, buddy. Two freaking stones. Just hoping it goes through, and this fire doesn't last very long. Okay. Let me eat a bit. Get a little leaf. So I don't know how to lower the rate of this fire going out, because it seems to be, yeah. What is this? I figured this is why I didn't want to happen. Ugh, now I gotta run to like a freaking. Stupid. Well, now you have a fire. And more than enough fuel. Go to sleep. Ah, you punk. Don't be picky. It's so warm. Good. You were cold earlier, now you're warm. Whoa. All right, the recording's gone on pretty long. I don't know if I've done enough to even give you guys an impression. Shut your mouth. You started like a freaking forest fire. Ooh, charcoal. No. Slightly thirsty because you've been like mucking around in a forest fire. Alright, that was fun. I kind of predicted that was going to happen, and I'm glad it kind of did. I think what happened was I had made the fire too big. But look at this, I got a ton of charcoal. I mean, seriously, I could have like a Texas sized barbecue. I'm actually kind of happy about that. That was great. Next time I'll do that instead of mucking around with leaves and twigs and stuff. Just start a freaking fire. Alright. What else can I do? I wish it would tell you what you can do with it. Craft build. 15 leaf. Pelt cape. How am I supposed to get pelt? One sharp stone, big one branch. Oh, that's pretty easy to build. Stone spear. Simple bone, stone arrow, simple quiver. Why are you hot again? Must be... Well, chill out. Why is it? What the heck did I do? Is it because of the temperature itself, or is it just hot? Alright guys, let's see. Holy crap. Everything's on fire. That's great. Oh, run, full run. I'm slightly hungry, yeah. But you're trying to run. I don't know, guys. That's pretty awesome. Oh, stump. What can you do with a stump? Yep. Looks like I destroyed the forest. Okay, so I need another stone to sharpen this stone. Why do you feel weak? Noob. Let me sharpen a stone, get a twig. Hopefully I can do it before that fire catches this thing on fire. What do you mean? Ah, you punk. Dino poop. Dino poop. Alright, let's try this. Again. Sharpen. Did it break the stone again? You an idiot. No fruits there. Alright, so this guy's gonna die soon, and if that's the case, we're gonna call it quits. If not, I guess I will find some other epic way to die. For this guy to die. Alright, so maybe I'll increase my gathering next time. Alright, whatever, sleep. So hopefully when it sleep will increase his health, at least over the threshold. Day 11. Why don't you sleep some more? Well, actually, I can't sleep really long. All right, let's take a stone. Let's sharpen that. Stop breaking a stone in a way that doesn't work for me. Stupid. Sweet, what is that? Can I kill this guy? Definitely not with just a stone. Maybe a smaller animal. All right, so hopefully I can carve it with this. Yay. Do you mean reduce? Ugh. No. Craft. Stone axe. I don't know if I'll be brave enough to kill one of these guys, but I think I'll go ahead and try that. Alternatively, I could set a fire. What do you feel weak? Eat some poop or something. More set fruit there, but I think it's spoiled. Okay, let me. These guys look peaceable. Looking for food. All right. Let me chop this down. Wow. Sweet. Right, I don't know if I actually hit the thing. Oh, wow. What can I craft or build from this? All right. Warm. Let me go drink some water. Man, there's a ton of poop here. Right, guys, so I am going to quit soon, but what I'm going to do is cause some trouble. All right. I don't know how this will play out. What? All right, so I need some sort of weapon. I'm bleeding. All right, so what are you gonna do about it? Oh, take a nap. Yeah. Nap you might not wake up from. Sneaky, sneaky. Yeah, whatever. Quick look at God mode. Look. fire. What the heck is that? Must be volcano. Totally burnt out the forest. Look at that destruction. That's great. I think that was the best part of this whatchamacallit. Let's see, how do I die, you. So this guy was pretty close to dying, must have been. I'm gonna take a look at the island. Okay, the island's not big. Pressing spacebar, by the way, to shoot these guys with lightning. Alright. I found it quite cumbersome, honestly. Oh, dude, I didn't know I killed a T-Rex with fire. But it is an interesting game from the perspective of how things are dynamically, I guess, dynamically generated, dynamically done. Just wish we had more crafting options, which I guess it's probably a priority now since it's been released as an early release on Steam by the developer. But interface is kind of not that intuitive, and the tutorial honestly took forever. It was like 30 minutes, and I only had like 40 minutes. Maybe 30 minutes of actual game time. It shows promise, and this is why I don't like buying pre-release games unless they're like the concept is like really close to what I like. Like this is. I really don't like pre-release games, because if I had paid whatever I paid for this and this game was like this and he left it like this or abandoned it like this, I would not be happy at all. It's interesting, but the interface is weird. The controls are a bit wonky, and things break too easily. I mean, what the heck is up with that? Maybe if he was able to, my character was able to carry more stuff, it wouldn't be as annoying. Stumble mechanic is annoying. Setting things on fire is awesome, but this fire pit really should contain the fire. It shouldn't have caused issues, honestly, but whatever. But interesting game. I will keep an eye on it. I don't know if I will do a let's play in the future. I'll have to see what the state of the game is like in the future. But wow, this is a really, really long episode. I'm sorry about that. I will take responsibility for reading the tutorials very slowly and not knowing what the hell is doing. Now I gotta find that word I said that I shouldn't have said and censor it out. Alright guys, thanks again for watching. I hope this informs you guys of whether this is a game you would want to buy or play. Hopefully I'll save you a couple bucks if you didn't like it or got you interested And anyways, I'll catch you guys later.